Hello friends, welcome to Aptrixy classes. This is RaMo and I'm here to explain a wonderful question of the day today from averages. So let us read this question and what it says. This question says that class P has boys to girls in this ratio 3:7. So that ratio of boys to girls has been given 3:7. Then it says class Q is there where girls to boys ratio is given to be 3:1. You need to be very attentive. This is boys to girls and this is girls to boys. So it is more important that you do not make mistakes in the exam, right? So it is better if you just do this, that you write 3:1 here so that you will have the clarity that actually boys to girls ratio here will be 1:3, because initially here boys to girls ratio has been given. Now it says if the number of students in class P is at least thrice as many as the number of students in class Q. One more information, that in class P there will be minimum 3 times number of student as compared to class Q. It is asking us to find the minimum percentage of boys when both classes are considered together, and these are the options provided here. This is a very wonderful question, and often the students get confused by seeing this question because it is talking about at least, it is talking about minimum percentage. But you should not worry, you should just analyze this question, and I am telling you, you can solve this question very easily using common sense, nothing else. Now let us understand this case first and let's try to solve this. So I'm coming here to write that if I say this is boy and this is girl and there are two classes given, P and Q. So I will write class P here and class Q here. So what is the boys to girls ratio here? It is given as 3:7. So I will write 3 here and I will write 7 here, and yes, this is ratio. Then in class Q, what is the ratio boys to girl? It is 1:3. I'm writing this like this. Now tell me please, we have to ultimately find minimum percentage of boys. Let's find out what is the percentage of boys given here. Clearly it is 30%, 3 out of total 10, because total here it will be 7 + 3 = 10, that is 30%. Here the percentage of boys will be 1 out of total 4, 3 + 1 will be total 4, that is 25%. Now another information that has been provided to us is that in class P, total number of students will be minimum 3 times of number of students in class Q. Now we need to use this information and solve this particular question. But you know what? If you have the idea of averages, you learn average in a correct way. Most people do not learn average in a correct way. They think average is just simply, you know, sum of all observation divided by number of all observation, right? It's a formula and you learn averages through formula, not like that. But if you learn averages visually, you can easily answer this question. At least we can reject a lot of options now. Try to understand. If I give you two values, like here, percentage of boys is 30%. I suppose write here 30%. And in the class Q, percentage of boys is 25%. I will write 25% here. Without doing anything, without even taking in what is the ratio of number of students in class P and Q, I am pretty sure that average will lie in the middle. This is the property of average. If you have two numbers, average always lies somewhere in the middle. It cannot be lesser than 25. It cannot be lesser than, more than 30. It has to be somewhere in between. Using it, let's see, are we able to reject some of the option? Yes. Any answer which is less than 25 has to be rejected. So therefore, option A is not possible. Now, any answer which is more than 30 can also be rejected. Even the answer which is equal to 30 will be rejected. It has to be in between. Even the answer which is equal to 25 can be rejected. Now, look, without even using this, that the number of students in class P is 3 times minimum number of students in class Q, we are able to reject 3 options using basic property of average with visual understanding. Now, we are left with 2 options, right? That is 28.75 and 27.5%. We have to find what is the right answer because we are not able to reject directly. Now I'm going to this statement and I'm going to use it. Now try to understand here. If I tell you that this correspond to, this is given, this correspond to class Q and this correspond to class P, 30% correspond to class P. Now it is given that this ratio will be minimum 3:1. That means this 3 can be more than 3. This 3 can be more than 3. It cannot be less than 3. So the ratio will be 3:1. This is the minimum ratio that you can have here. Now one more thing you understand in averages, if you learn averages visually, this is the midpoint of 25 and 30. That midpoint will be 27.5%. Midpoint, right? So if they would have been in the ratio 1:1, the average would have been exactly in between. Average here means percentage of boys, because that is what is being used here. Now, if they would have been in 1:1, average would have been exactly in the middle, that is 27.5%. But look clearly that class P is actually in majority. It is having more value as compared to class Q in terms of number of students. Therefore, average will be shifted towards 30. It will have more impact on average because the number corresponding to it is more as compared to the number corresponding here in class Q. So now clearly your answer should be more than 27.5%. And yes, therefore you can mark this answer to be D. Right? Now you may have one idea. This has to be, look, more than 27.5%. Your actual answer will be between 27.5% and 30%. It cannot be 27.5%. Right? So that you need to understand. 27.5% will be the answer when these numbers are exactly, these numbers are equal. Ratio should be 1:1. So therefore you can mark the answer. Suppose you ask that what if none of these is also there? You need not to worry. Even if suppose none of these is there, let us understand what is the meaning of minimum percentage of boys. Try to understand. This is the minimum ratio I have to consider. 3:1. Now this ratio will be minimum 3:1, right? So it can be in minimum case when we are talking about, it will be 3:1. Now try to understand. As soon as this 3 will increase, because this is 3 is the minimum value. It can be 4, it can be 5, it can be 6. As soon as it will increase, the average will start moving in this direction more and more. The more value you take here, the average will be more shifted towards 30. That means average will keep on increasing. What is average here? Percentage of boys. Now, if we want to minimize percentage of boys when both classes are combined, to make it minimum, we will try to keep the average minimum. When average will be minimum? When we consider this to be 3. When we consider this to be 3, then only average will be minimum. Otherwise, you can just simply think, if it will be 4, it is going to be more closer towards 30. Therefore, to minimize it, we have to consider this ratio only, 3:1. Now you can easily find the answer. If it is 3:1, and I'm just solving it for the sake that if none of these is there in the option and you are not able to mark it directly, then you have to go further and solve it. Now you know, this is 3, this is 30%, this is 1, this is 25%. So how will you solve it? 3 into 30 will be 90, plus 1 into 25 will be 25, divided by 3 plus 1, 4, the weighted average expression, right? So you are going to get 115 divided by 4, which will give you 28.75%. Alright, that's the answer, right? Even you can find this value orally if you are a little bit intelligent. So how I will find it orally, just try to understand. You know what you have to do first? You take 130 out. I'm just going to explain it here. Suppose I'm having a value 30 and 25 here, and I tell you they are in 3:1. How to find average visually, right? Try to understand what I'm going to say here. I'm just going to take 130 out from here, 130 only. So if I take 130 out and 125, their average will be how much? Their average will be 27.5. So I'm going to write it. I have taken 130 out, so it will be left with only 2. And 130 I have taken out and I have combined with 25. Their average will be how much? 27.5. And since 125 and 130 will become 2 elements, so this is the rearrangement I am writing. Now their weights are equal or not? 1:1. 2:2 is nothing but 1:1. Their average will be exactly in middle. You can just simply see this overall gap is 2.5. So this gap will be 1.25. So that's how it will be 28.75. you know, learn to visualize things, because if your visual understanding improves, even the average can be done visually like this. Hope you all enjoyed this, but do one thing. I'm going to give you all a homework. Try it out. Tell me if this minimum word is not there. And I ask you this word to be maximum. I'm changing the question now for you. That is your homework. Make this minimum maximum. And tell me, find the maximum percentage of boys when both classes are considered together. And I want you to comment your answers. That's your homework. Don't forget to do it. Do comment, please, that what will be maximum percentage of boys when both classes are combined together. That's your homework. Do comment. I'll tell you the answer in the next question of the day. Thank you everyone for watching it. Do share with more and more students for their benefit. Thank you.